We're here in prime time, just about set for a Sunday night matchup on EA Sports.
I don't know which team has the better tight end, but I do know that that could very well be the difference in this game today.
Well, if you made me choose between the two, I'll tell you what. I'll just say you take one. I don't care who you take. I'll take the other one because they're both that good. They can do it all. As I say, you hear me say it every once in a while. They're all in one. That means they can do anything you want.
And with that kick, these two rivals are ready to go. Ellington's going to start his return. And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line. He'll stand back beyond the center in the gun. Got drilled as he throws it. Here's the Bears offense. This is an efficient group. Last week, turning the football over just once. Second down here. Here's the handoff and they'll run it. Going to be a penalty here. That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. Offensive line could be in for a long day based on that one.
Yeah, bad job that time. They give up the sack. But look, when you talk about this offensive line, they're pretty good. So I think they'll just find a way to get it done. They still should have a nice, solid day.
The Bears are at the line facing third down, which was not an issue for them last week as they converted a number of times in crucial situations. Quarters formation here for the defense. He's drilled as he throws.
The Bears don't have a lot of options on third and long situations. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
This punt will not be returned. It will never see the field of play as it sails out of bounds. first down at the 31. Johnson's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it. It's first down as they head to the line. The Vikings are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. Hand off.
That's a tackle right near the 48.
Here's a look at the Vikings offense, and their strength comes in the passing game, ranking currently fourth in the NFL.
After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8. He's hit as he throws it. Third and 8 coming up after the incompletion.
Bridgewater's lined up, empty backfield.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
White's got it.
Receivers get scared sometimes running that slant route. They know their linebackers inside running towards them because they're watching the quarterback's eyes.
The line of scrimmage, the 36. The Vikings will come out in the pistol. First down at the 36. Catch made. Gains 16.
Well, the quarterback showed off his arm strength that time, didn't he? He put the football right on the money, on a line, right into the receiver's hands.
They come to the line, and it's first down.
Now the defensive line is shifting to the right.
Staying with the passing game on first down. Jerick McKinnon has the reception.
When you play zone coverage, the quarterback might have to hold the football just a little longer, but these guys nowadays, you play zone, they know how to throw and catch and get it done.
That pass play picked up only 4. Second down and 6 coming up.
Good job by the defensive line shifting all down inside. I think they're expecting a run up the middle.
Second and 6. Probably should have had that one, but it goes incomplete. Now a look at the Bears defense. This is a unit that's a quarterback's nightmare. Last week, they got to the quarterback 7 times for sacks. The Vikings lined up, bunch formation. Third down and 6. Flag comes out. This will be a field goal attempt from 33 yards out. Drives it through for the field goal. That field goal gives them a leg up here midway through the first quarter.
Makes you feel really good about what you did during the week here. Anytime you can get points on the board early in a football game, it makes you think all that practice was worth it.
Hamilton is tackled down. And a run back of about 14. The Bears weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt. As they take the field here, do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of the information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three and out business.
Well, that's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad business.
Kendricks there to take him down. Here's how the Vikings line up on defense. Can anyone on this defensive unit find out a way to stop the passing attack? Second and 10. He has the ground. Gains 20. That's his first reception today.
The old-fashioned way of picking up big yardage is running the fly route on the outside. Show the speed of the receiver and the strength of the quarterback's arm. What a nice completion.
Here's the first snap after the big play. They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun. Martellus Bennett with the reception. McKinney's there to make the tackle.
Nice catch by the receiver, but it still doesn't get a first down.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. The Bears come out in a two tight end set. The Bears have it at the 34. Throws the pass. Picks up about five.
When you talk about throwing the football into open space, that's almost always against zone defenses. That's what we saw that time. Good job by the quarterback throwing it in there.
Almost to the 40 at the 39-yard line.
Get ready.
The Bears need to get to the 43 to pick up a first.
D-line is shifting inside. They're pinching. I think they're expecting to run up the middle.
Gains 11.
Well, you can't play man-to-man, Jim, every single play. Every once in a while, you got to throw in the zone. That's what they did this past play. Hey, it was a good idea. It just didn't work.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. That picks up 11.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
First down here after the run. For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Gets the handle here. Kendricks there that time for the tackle.
You got to be big, strong. You got to be tough. And we saw all those qualities that time in that run. Look at the broken tackles.
They'll try over again on second down. The Vikings come out in a dime package. Langford's handed the football. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
You're running back in this league and you pick up first downs and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
Snapping the football from the 28. We're back here to start the second quarter. And partner, when you're in a tight defensive game like this, what does an offense have to do to open this game up?
I think what happens sometimes in situations like this, Jim, You know, the offense, they plan for the game and what they're going to do, but they come out there that first series or two and they go, wow, these guys are better in person than they were on the film. So you've got to adjust physically. I think now that they have adjusted, we'll see if they can make some things happen.
Get ready. Team.
Now he's going to change the play, and look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
On the money. Robinson's the one who brings him to the ground.
The key to being a really good route runner and running these drag routes across the field is show some courage. Don't worry about what's in front of you. The quarterback will take care of that.
Set up now at the 26.
The Vikings with two extra defensive backs in the dime.
Second down and 8.
Pass is intercepted. He's brought down.
We got a tight one early in the second quarter, and now the offense will look to build on the lead coming off the interception.
Yeah, you know, that was a good job by the defense, taking nothing away from them. But what was the offense thinking with that play call and that throw by the quarterback?
The Vikings come to the line in a tight game here in the second quarter. The score's 3-0. The Vikings now move the chains. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. First and 10. He's got the catch. He's going to be tackled right around the 49.
Well, if you guard the tight end close, it sometimes that doesn't matter. They're so big and they got long arms, they can still make the catch. Quarterbacks give them a chance, they get it done.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. The give. In the end, it picks up only a yard.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short gain.
Coming to the line of scrimmage right at midfield.
Bridgewater will have it in the pistol.
Second and 9.
He'll go ground. He'll pick up 7 this time.
What that run does, it just puts the offense in a good situation. So a good, positive run.
It'll be third down. The Bears with a nickel look here on defense. Comes down with no. The defender tips it out.
This is called managing the football game as a head coach. What are you doing here? You've got a lead. It's close. It's fourth down. It's short yardage. You're near midfield. Don't do it. Punt the football away. And if the other team's going to go ahead, make them drive the length of the field.
That punt sets up the defense now in excellent position as they're able to down the football inside the 10. The Bears, and I have to wonder, where are they going to be mentally after that last drive when they were moving the football only to give it away on an interception? How are they going to be out there on this possession?
Well, I think it's tough. I really do, Jim. You know, nowadays, quarterbacks, it seems like all we judge them on, do they throw interceptions or not? And once you throw one, it's out there. You've got to get over that mental block, and you've got to keep playing hard and aggressive football. That's the only way you can have success.
That's reception number 2 for him.
I don't know what the answer is when it comes to guarding these tight ends now. There's just not much you can do. I'll tell you the best way to stop the tight end, rush the quarterback.
This will be second down. They'll go ground. He's got some daylight. He's taken down at the 30.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. First and 10. To the ground. And they tackle him down at the 37-yard line.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second and 3 after that last carry. From the shotgun, the Bears get a first down, and he's tackled down after picking up the first.
Nice job that time by the tight end, makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
First down here. The Bears line up, split backfield. Keeps it here. Has his target. Running room. That brings the play to an end.
What a nice catch by the receiver. Getting past the yard markers, makes the catch, and gets a first down.
The Bears now inside the 20. A week ago, they converted time and time again inside the red zone. First and goal from the 9. Oh, Chicago in the end zone.
Man, the defense has to be down at something like this. They allow the offense to score that touchdown in the red zone. My gosh, you only have such a small part of the field to defend, and they just didn't get the job done that time.
The Vikings are ready to return the kickoff. And he'll start his return. And the tackle's made. The offense will start their drive from about the 31. The Vikings heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative. Get the defense off guard. Make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity.
First down at the 31. Room to work. And at the 37, he'll be brought down.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second down and 3 following that nice run. Bridgewater's going to be in the pistol here.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
McKinnon has the catch. Tackle down right around the 47.
Well, that's a great feeling, isn't it, for an offense to throw a short pass to the running back and get a long gain. This guy is in there because he can run it, he can catch it, and he can make things happen.
This next play coming from the 47-yard line. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. With two hands, he has it.
Do the little things right. When you do those right, you get big victories. And doing it right is what this offensive player did that time. Had a chance to get out of bounds, stop the clock, give his offense more chances. Really good job by the offensive player.
That short pass play picked up six. It's now second down and four.
The Vikings will go with the pistol on this play. The Vikings snap it at the 41. And incomplete. Didn't get his feet down.
When you see this cover two defense as a quarterback, you got to know where to throw the football. That time he did not make a good decision.
We have a review coming from the booth.
There's no question he caught the ball, but there is a question whether or not he got both feet in bounds.
Well, first off, you want to make sure it's a clean catch on the sidelines. Does he have possession of the football? And then once you declare he has possession of the football, let's look down at both feet, see if they're in bounds, and don't forget, you must maintain possession of the football as you go to the ground.
The Vikings snap it at the 36. He's tackled at the 30.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Second and three after that last carry.
The Vikings at the line of scrimmage. Split backfield. Bridgewater's got it in the gun. Jerick McKinnon has the reception.
Nice job that time by the runner. Gets out of bounds after the play. You got under 2 minutes, and you need to stop the clock, so he gets it done.
Bridgewater's. Hold on a minute. They're going to stop play and take another look at that last one. There's no question he caught the ball, but there is a question whether or not he got both feet in bounds.
Well, first off, you want to make sure it's a clean catch on the sidelines. Does he have possession of the football? And then once you declare he has possession of the football, let's look down at both feet, see if they're in bounds, and don't forget, you must maintain possession of the football as you go to the ground.
The Vikings signal for a timeout. They have two remaining. This is third down. Bridgewater's going to take it from the gun. This play will hold up. He's in bounds.
What a good job by the quarterback that time. He saw the defensive back inside the receiver, and he leads that receiver to the sideline on that corner route.
Breaking huddle at the 10. Let's see how they back up the big play here. Handoff made. Breaks out of the tackle.
The defense will take the penalty.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Looks like they're in press coverage here.
Look out. They're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
So, first and goal to go. McKinnon has the catch.
Well, but it's under 2 minutes to go. Good job by the offensive ball carrier that time. He knows he can get no more yards. He steps out of bounds to stop the clock.
Just 4 yards away from the end zone. Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. Second and goal from the four. They'll meet him this time behind the line.
Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third and goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
The Bears signal for the timeout, and that's the first one they've used. About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. Third and goal from the seven. Here's the quick toss. And that gains one. Defense now signaling for a timeout. Should be an easy one here. The kick is through for three. Approaching the half, and that field goal has to make them feel good about their play as they keep things close.
Yep, no doubt about it. What they're saying to the opponents, look out. This game is not over. We're going to be here all day long.
And no return as this goes for a touchback.
The Bears offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
It's a two tight end formation. He runs with it right up the gut. Smith in on the tackle.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
They'll run it here. He's churning ahead. No one's going to get him now. The 10, and stride, and he's home for the touchdown.
To me, still one of the most exciting plays in NFL football. A long running play for a touchdown. And how about that one? It had it all in its speed. Good moves, good blocks. Exciting touchdown.
Inside of the uprights. The Bears getting ready to kick it away. He'll take it from the one.
There is nothing like a good return when you talk about special teams. Good blocking, the speed of the returner gets down the field, and after that tackle, now they have good starting field position.
Walsh set now to attempt the field goal. Puts it through the uprights. Needed plenty of leg on that one. A good first half of action here. And soon we'll be sending you to Orlando and to our host, Larry Ridley. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. It'll be a touchback. The Vikings talk things over at the intermission. And I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. Catch the defense by surprise. They need to call one of those right here and right now to get this offense going.
Minnesota in for the score. Just moments into the third quarter, and they've wasted no time asserting themselves, finding the end zone, and going in front, Phil.
Well said, Jim. They did not waste any time on the offensive side, but I'll say this. The defense, they wasted halftime. They must not have been listening to their coach.
Toss to the outside. They will not find a way into the end zone, so they'll only get 6 points out of the trip. The Bears are ready to return the kick. Ellington's running this one out. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23.
The Bears' offense looks unstoppable. Touchdown drives the last two times they've had it. Here they go again, Phil.
Yeah, they've been very good, Jim. They're taking advantage of situations and scoring touchdowns, and we know that's what you must do. If you don't get these touchdowns, what happens later in the game always comes back to bite you.
The Bears take it from the 23. Takes the hit, throws. The Vikings defense now is going to go nickel. Second down and 10. The reception by Jeffrey. And it's a gain of maybe 5.
You got to be able to adjust when you run these drag routes across the field. The throw cannot always be right on target. Can you reach behind, make the catch, and keep going full speed? That's the sign of a good receiver.
Third and 5 still to go, even after that last completion.
Look what the defensive line is doing. They're all pinching down inside. They're expecting a run. This has got to be a blitz. Look how everybody's crowding the line of scrimmage.
Third and 5. Reaches out and grabs it. That's another reception, giving him 2.
The Bears look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
The Bears come out with a split backfield. First down and 10. Screen. But the ball is knocked out incomplete.
Good anticipation that time by the defender. He gets to the receiver just as the football is arriving, and he makes a beautiful hit to knock the football loose.
Two tight ends on the field here. The Bears from the 37. And the reception by Brandon LaFell.
The Bears, good job that time, moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
First down here after the completion. Out of the shotgun. Brent Celek has the catch. Waynes is there to take him down.
When you run that drag route across the field, it is not as easy as it looks. You're running fast. You have to catch the football right in stride, and you cannot see what's in front of you.
And here we have second down. Here's the handoff for a gain of about 5. He's got over 130 rushing yards today.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Third down on the way. The Vikings defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. From the shotgun. Makes the reception. And a flag is down. The defense accepts the penalty.
Oh, man, Jim, this just drives everybody crazy. The fans, even announcers like you and I, it's third and short, and you throw and complete the pass, but it's still not enough to get the first down. Look out here. They're going to blitz. They're all packing the line of scrimmage. Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
The Bears snap it at the 36. Langford's got the catch and the first.
The Bears just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
They come to the line at the 31-yard line.
Now first and 10. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. The Vikings go with the dime formation here on defense. Feeds him again. Barnes able to read that play and make the hit. What a drive this has been. Dropping back now into the shotgun. Has his man. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Good job by the defense. They're well taught, well schooled by the defensive coordinator. They know in situations like this, if it's thrown short of the first down marker, they're good. They come up, make the tackle. Now we have fourth down.
The field goal attempt is good. It's good. And as we move closer to the final quarter, that field goal gives them the lead.
As a player, you start watching that clock, and you start thinking about the end of the game when you get the lead somewhere in the third. So I know what's in their thinking right now. Let's see if this defense can go out and hold the other team's offense.
That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. The Vikings offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they still have it in them to issue a repeat performance.
Well, what you saw in that last drive was everything just came together perfectly for them. The experience of the football team, the talent of the players, and the coaches helped them out. They got it done.
First down at the 20. Has the grab, and they bring it down at the 36-yard line.
The Vikings did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and, you know, you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Bridgewater's now completed four in a row. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. The Bears lined up in the nickel. Halfback sent in motion. First down at the 36. Here's the handoff. Out of the strong eye. Press coverage all the way. Bridgewater's got no one behind him. Just a quarterback waiting for the snap.
When linebackers move around like this, you know what it means? Nothing confuses no one.
The Vikings take it from the 33. It's intercepted.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The Bears step back onto the field on offense. Their last possession resulted in a field goal.
Well, I know this. It was good defense on the other side. That's what made them kick that field goal. So the defense is feeling good about the fact that they stopped that momentum by the offense and made them kick that field goal.
First down at the 48. The catch is made by Alshon Jeffrey. Third catch today so far.
The Bears coaching staff has done a good job of mixing things up today on the first down. The pass catches the defense off guard. They pick up solid yards. Now it's second and short.
At the 45-yard line.
Look out. The defense is showing a blitz here.
Second and three. Ellington on the screen. Bears, touchdown. Caught his first touchdown of the season. The Bears for the extra point kick. It's good. The Vikings are ready to return the kickoff. Touchback now as the ball comes out to the 20. The Vikings offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there, be aggressive, and see if you can score some points.
Bridgewater's ready for the snap, empty backfield.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
Climbs the ladder, and he has it.
When you pick up first downs against the defense, they will get tired. That time, nice job by the offense getting the first down, even though they're losing here in the game.
Bridgewater's completion percentage, 70% on the day. At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. Bridgewater will have it in the pistol. First and 10. Smith makes the catch. Smith's tackled down after a gain of 5.
Hard to guard these tight ends now in the NFL. It really puts the defense in like a quandary. Do we use a big guy? Well, the big guy's not fast enough. We use a small guy, well, he's not big enough. They get pushed around. I don't know what you're going to do. Just make sure you're a good tackler after they catch it. Tiger.
Second down and 5. Brings it into his body. The tackle's made, and the first down is picked up.
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches, running these short drag routes across the field. That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
The Vikings offense tries to continue some momentum, still possessing the football as the final quarter gets underway. Bridgewater's alone in the backfield. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. Jerick McKinnon has the reception. Second and 7 on the way. It in. White's tackled down after a gain of 5. And the offense will need 3 yards here on third down after the completion. The Bears defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel.
Look at the linebackers moving around. They're trying to confuse the quarterback.
Reaches out and snatches it. At the line of scrimmage, the 34. They bring in the extra tight end.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
First and 10. McKinnon has the catch.
The Vikings have been awesome today on first down. That time, it's a nice play design. They throw the football, picks up solid yards. Second and short. Boy, that's what every offense likes to be in.
Bridgewater's now completed his last seven passes.
Coming to the line at the 25.
Oh, look at that. The defensive line shifted over to the left.
Handoff. Tackle's made, and the first down is picked up.
You're running back in this league, and you pick up first downs, and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has the injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with a Vikings official. The injury appears to be minor, so the trainers are just looking him over one last time, and then he'll get back on the field.
Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players, your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back. They need to make a big play here.
Six for the Vikings. He's caught his seventh touchdown pass of the season. The Vikings for the point after. Driving extra point is good. The Vikings setting up for the kickoff. And a touchback here will bring the ball out to the 20. Bears have been in a fight today. The score's 24-22.
Get ready. Break 38.
Out of the shotgun formation. Sharif Floyd with the sack.
You're talking about a bonus. When you get a defensive tackle that can get in the backfield and sack the quarterback, that is something special. Great job that time by the big D tackle.
That's second down coming up. The Vikings sat at the line. Dime package. Langford's taking the handoff. Waynes is in on the tackle.
The Bears offense, they know it's more than just about their defense. The offense did a good job that time picking up the first down. That's what you want to do. You got a small lead in the second half. Keep getting those first downs and eat that clock up.
Heading to the line at the 22.
First down following the long play. Double tight end formation.
Hey, how about that? The defensive line, everybody's shifting to the left. I think they're expecting a run.
Bennett's taken down at the 18.
If it was me, I would cover the short receivers and force this guy to throw it down the field. You're behind by a few points. You've got to try and force the issue. The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score. They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
Complete to Jeffrey. Gains 13.
Nice job that time by the offense, getting the first down inside the red zone. And it's a good thing they got a quarterback with a strong arm, because you've got to throw into some tight spots in the red zone.
Stepping up to the line of scrimmage, the 5-yard line.
Let's go.
First and goal from the 5. And it's batted down.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So if you're a defender, read the quarterback. You make a quick break on the football. Hey, you get in position like this, you can knock it down.
Breaking huddle at the 5.
They're trying to confuse the offense here. Look at everybody crowding the line of scrimmage.
Second and goal from the 5. The Bears, touchdown, Chicago Bears. That's his 5th receiving touchdown this year. Makes the PAT. Ready to swing his leg as aggressively as possible and send the football down to the end zone. He'll have a chance to take off. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. The Vikings now ready to take over again on offense. They were successful on their previous drive, getting the ball all the way to the end zone. I'm sure they're looking for more of the same right now.
Oh, absolutely. That's what you always want. You want to find your way to the end zone. And so many people contributed on that last drive, and you've got to give the coaches a lot of credit for putting the players in excellent position. Defensive line shifting to the right there.
First down at the 25. It's caught by Kevin White. White's met at the 37. That's reception number 4 for him. The Vikings still trail, but as we look at the passing numbers, it's hard to find much fault with them. Bridgewater's numbers, though, speak to a team that could be winning if other things like their defense were doing their part here, partner.
Well, yeah, that's right. The defense has got to hold their end up, but the offense, they've been very, very good. The quarterback has been accurate. He has been smart, and that always gives you a chance when your quarterback is playing that well.
First down and 10. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. Playing press coverage to the outside. And now on first down, they'll go back to the air. Bridgewater's going to take off with it. That's a gain of 10.
Well, we just don't talk about it enough. He is so good, has such quick feet. And then when he gets outside, if you make him run, he will. And a good job there picking up some extra yards.
Coming to the line at the 33. The Bears will come out in the dime.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
The Vikings take it from the 33. Makes the catch for about 4.
Jim, here in the fourth quarter. you're down, what you want to do is just keep that football moving. That time it's a short throw. He gets the completion. Good job.
Bridgewater's completion percentage, 80% on the day. Second and six coming up.
Look at the defensive line shifting all down to the inside. They're pinching. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
The Vikings have it at the 29. The defense gets a sack.
Well, you expect defensive ends to get sacks because they come around the outside. But when you get pressure from the inside and the defensive tackle gets a sack, that's just an added bonus.
To go before this one's in the books. Third down coming up, needing a first at this point. Quarters formation here for the defense. The Vikings will take the snap from the 40. Charles Johnson with the catch.
Jim, they got momentum on their side right now. They are making everything work. That was a nice play. They pick up another first down, and they got a good drive going here.
First down. Pressure on every snap now. Now first and 10. Jerick McKinnon has the reception and picks up about 3. The Vikings will take a second here to talk things over as they call a timeout on second down. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. The Bears come out in a dime package.
Now he's going to change the play. And look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Second down and 7. The ball is taken out of his hands.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
This will be the 8th play of this drive. That's a mindless error on the offense. Huge 3rd and long coming up, and they're certainly in 4-down territory as well. 3rd and 12. Going for it on 4th down. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage.
If you think you can get a playoff quickly and not use a timeout, you go with the hurry up offense. That time, a good job by the coach and the quarterback.
Bridgewater's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Touchdown as we near the end of this one. Late in the 4th, and even after that touchdown, they're going to need a miracle in the closing moments.
Well, I think what we're finding out, the game is never over. Play it till the end. They did a great job of scoring there. Now can they find a way to get that football back and maybe win this game?
He made it. The the Vikings need a score, so they're going to be going with an onside kick. Everything hinged on them recovering that onside kick, and they failed to do so.
Well, Jim, when you're doing the onside kick, you really got to hope for that perfect bounce of the football. That time it did not happen. That's why they didn't recover.
The Bears offense getting ready to start this drive, and things are looking good for them at this stage of the game, partner.
Yeah, this is where it gets tough, though, Jim. They got to find a way, make the right play call to get one first down. If you do that, that puts the other team in a very tough situation.
Mounting a serious drive.
Good job by the defense, all shifting inside. They're expecting a run up the middle.
The Vikings will stop the clock here with this timeout, needing to preserve time. Second down now. An extra tight end on the field for this one. Gets the handle here. Running right through the trenches. A foot race to the end zone. The 10 taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
You don't see a lot of them anymore because we have so many good tackling safeties in the NFL. But not this time. That long run goes for a touchdown. It was about the moves and the blocks down the field. Terrific job by the offense.
The Bears for the extra point kick. Extra point is good. The Vikings are ready to return the kickoff.